over the country, Afghan voters have been choosing their next president. In the capital, the roads have been quiet, with men and women focusing on exercising their right to guide the future of the country.
Well, the streets of Kabul may be quite empty, but that doesn't stop people from voting. Behind me, women are choosing to cast their vote, and they tell me they're not frightened.
Indelible ink is used as one of many anti-fraud measures to make sure the election is fair. Then the voter's registration card is punched before they collect their ballot papers. It's not just one of over 30 prospective presidents voters must choose. In Kabul City, over 500 provincial council members were up for election as well. Election officials say the turnout is better than anticipated. Voters overcame any fears they might have had with the hope their choice in president might deliver improvements to their everyday lives. As this lady leaves after casting her vote, she voices the bravery of all those who came to vote today. This is Ruth Owen in Afghanistan for the NATO channel.
From a certain point of view, it's going very, very well. We had some small attacks, but not linked with the elections. The overall situation is calm, and we have a lot of people coming to the polling centers from Helmand to Kandahar, all the way down to Nimbus and Dikkundi. So that's very encouraging from our point of view. Around Heerenhaasie South, most of the people are used to insecurity. But they also saw that the Afghan National Security Forces and ISAF over the last couple of months conducted lots of operations to expand the security footprint we had. And we told them that the ISAF forces were going to stay as long as needed. And the combination of the good cooperation between the Afghan National Security Forces and ISAF and the more boots on the ground we have in ISAF led to a situation in which I think that the people felt safe, that's one, and secondly, it's fair to say that Afghan people have the courage, they're very brave people, to go out and cast a vote, although there is a threat. We were completely ready with the preparations for the elections, and we, that means the Afghan partners and we, and actually we supported the Afghans, but the Afghans were the one who organized it and were responsible for the organization and security. So it just shows you that from my point of view, not only the fact that we have elections today, but the fact that they are organized by the Afghans themselves, that is a great step forward for this country. I see it especially here in the south, which is an area which was seen as a problematic area where only few people would cast their vote. I see it, but touch wood, but I see it as a great success in tomorrow.
Excellent. Sir, is there anything else you'd like?